I guess, are we ready?
Good countdown.
Cool. Okay.
3, 2, 1, go. So, hello everyone. I'm Adam Timothy.
Biscuit 047.
I'm Essentia, and I've got my two girls here.
And this is...
with Adam Bilbo.
And this is Kingdom Hearts, Birth by Sleep, Final Mix HD. So, if you want to start off.
Well, at the beginning, we can skip the tutorial of this by having, a completed file, right?
Yes.
Yeah, completed file, so we can go right to picking the characters, so that really helps in speedruns, so we don't have to do a 10-15 minute tutorial of basic stuff.
First challenge, not selecting the wrong character.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Oh, whoops, we are doing that.
Aqua is generally considered the best anyway, because she really excels in magic, and magic is really strong in this game, and as it turns out, we're going to be abusing something that was put in 2.5, which is the modifier of EXP0. It works a little differently. They wanted to fix the problems with Birth by Sleep in level 1 in the original, so they actually made it work like 1.5 level 1, which means, you'll see. I maybe I shouldn't spoil it.
By the way, I think anyone who runs this game can agree that they hate this fight.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, unfortunately, the game kind of kicks off with, I think, the two most random fights of the game, the two biggest time losses. We actually just got done doing a Birth by Sleep Aqua Critical Mode tournament within the community, and there was a lot of places where people were kind of digging holes, deficits in the race because of these two fights. But it's just kind of your starting thing. It's something to get through.
Yeah, so typically in a regular run, you would want this to be sub 2 minutes to want to continue, but... You can't really control this. The orbs don't really stagger. They go wherever they want. If you hit a finisher and don't kill them, they can fly across the room and you'll have to chase them down. It's not a fun fight. It's easy, it's just not fun.
That's probably like a high 150. The biggest thing with that fight is that when orbs go flying across the screen, if they hit each other, they both self-destruct. So to get the fastest fight, you want to send the orbs flying and just hope that they collide. If they don't collide, you have to go chasing them down. So it's a big risk, high risk, high reward situation.
Yeah, and a lot of people reset the orbs a lot if they don't get good luck.
Mm-hmm.
Like there are people that, even though if it's like a 10-second deficit, they'll be like, nope, not dealing with that.
It kind of ranges with each person. I know, Adam, one time you got a record with like a 211 orbs or something.
Yeah, I don't reset the orbs.
Yeah.
Too many black load screens to go through. So.
Yeah. The unfortunate thing is this game doesn't have data install, so...
It's not quite as bad as PSP load times, but it's still pretty comparable to them.
Yeah, but you lose time in like D-links and command styles, all that stuff.
Yeah, as long as the world map time though says 2 minutes, it means the old fight was fine. So, first order, go to Castle of Dreams. I'll be picking up a chest immediately with a crystal in it, fleeting crystal specifically. If you want to explain the whole loading system with crystals and the commands and whatnot.
The loading system?
Loading system.
Oh, no. Oh. Well, okay, so.
Basically,
sure, essentially, you get it.
Just
in this one, the only way to get abilities, like combo boost, second chance, all those things, is by using the melding system, where you take two commands, like fire or ice, whatever, and you combine them together to get a stronger command. But then, if you use crystals with them, they'll give you an added ability, like second chance or whatever.
Yeah, the big ones we'll be getting are Magic Haste, Second Chance, and Once More.
Yeah.
The ability depends quite strongly on the combination. You've got to level up your commands in the field in order to actually meld them. So part of the route is actually efficiently leveling your commands while doing fights.
Yeah. It's also a chance that I'll get a command that I don't want around 2 thirds in. It's only a 10% chance, so hopefully it doesn't happen. Find out when we get them.
Basically, a fusing failure.
Yeah, it's technically the better ability. It's stronger, but for the use in this run, it's worse.
Yeah, all the chests he's picking up, other than the synthing crystals, the melding crystals, are to sell so we can buy more spells, which he'll be doing very shortly.
Hey.
I'm just walking forward.
She had to go.
Yeah.
So real quick, while he's about to go into this menu here, I have one more special donation I want to read off. From Vulgin, just Vulgin. I've got a $162.99 donation. Many thanks to Adam Timothy Zero for being a great sport for the Aqua Ventus bid war, and to J Hobbs and Jaraxxus One for donating astounding amounts of money to a great cause. Just to show you I'm a good sport, this will finish off both extra boss fights for Birth by Sleep, as I know Adam has been wanting to show them all off. Enjoy the run. Thank you very much. So yeah, that officially finishes off all the Kingdom Hearts super boss fights that we've come to show for you guys. So once again, thank you for all your generosity.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Luigi.
So he's about to do the Jacka score, and the problem with this fight is he can go wherever he wants, and sometimes he'll get the perfect pattern where he won't run into enemies, but most of the time he'll spawn them, and then you have to save him.
He has five paths, 4 out of 5 spawn enemies, and you have to kill them. The fifth one, he just runs straight to the end. So we hope for the fifth path. I've yet to find a way to manipulate which path he chooses.
Yeah, we've tried. It's not like position based or anything like that. He just goes wherever he wants. And you gotta be sure not to like stand in front of him either, because I can stop him. And you don't want him to get hit ever, or he'll drop the key and take forever to pick it back up. So he's gonna quickly try to kill these three enemies and stall those ones over there. So Jack should, it's because he walked in front of him, so Jack kind of didn't really start running right away. So now we're going to see where he goes.
It's a bad pattern. He needs to go to the right to not spawn anything.
Okay. The good news is he didn't spawn the bruisers, so.
Okay.
He's right near the exit once he does Spellweaver Finisher.
Red Hot Chili sniped him.
No.
Oh my god. It didn't delay him.
Yeah.
Just push
him.
That's crazy. So again, you might be wondering, again, the way this ended up working out for the bid war is that it ended up being Ventus versus Terra versus Aqua, and it was all any percent. As it turns out, level 1 Aqua critical is actually the fastest way to beat this game with Aqua. You might be wondering why that is a thing. In the next fight, you will find out.
We'll explain it after.
You've seen my damage up to this point. It took 1 to 2 blizzards to kill each enemy, so it's not great.
Yeah, basically, what we want to do a lot is build up our command gauge to go into a command style, which right now is just Spellweaver, but that's what we want. And then we have to build it up again to get the finisher of it, and that's what we're going to want. So he's going to have to hope the curse coach doesn't go too far to the side at random times. We usually have to deal with some attack at some point. So you have to react accordingly so you don't die. Because, like, remember, this is level 1, so you could still die on these fights.
That was a really quick pattern.
Yeah. So now he's kind of looping him with a finisher combo. Spellweaver will keep staggering him until he gets the finisher. And here you go.
You're dead.
So this is why Aqua's the fastest Kingdom Hearts speedrun.
Yes.
And not Aqua level 1.
Yeah.
Level 1 critical specifically.
Yeah. And it's not like it gets spammed the whole time. We do have other options, but it is used a lot because it's an instant bar or more of damage on a boss. So the other characters can't really do anything like
with
that.
With your starting Keyblade too.
Yeah.
Right.
Explain the stats.
Yeah, it's similar to 1.5. The XP Zero ability does have like hidden properties, and one of them is the Keyblade doesn't matter because your strength stat kind of really doesn't matter. It tries to auto-scale you a bit, so...
Yeah, it disregards any time of damage modification, like fire boosts, strength stat, none of those are considered for your damage.
Mm-hmm. They tried their best to make a workaround for how poor level 1 was done in their original BBS, but this is what we got, and it's good for speedruns.
Yeah.
Is there any point you guys make use of that weird Monopoly
board
game?
No.
That would be bad.
I don't think there's a single category for this game besides 100%. That
I was going to say, even in the early days, did they ever consider it?
There was one route that I tested that used it.
Yeah, I say they, but Adam is actually one of the oldest. I always bring up Puexel myself, Axel Ryman, is like the old boys of the community. Adam was one of the first people I knew besides Essentia that actually seriously ran this category. So
there was also like Fragmaster too.
Yeah, Fragmaster did a little bit.
I wouldn't say that I ever really seriously ran it.
Well, you know, back in those days, it was like, I did a run, yay.
So we have sliding dash equipped, and we actually do use that for movement. It is a little faster, so he'll probably be using it.
Yeah, I hit an enemy because it allows me to go straight from sliding dash into another cartwheel.
And now, an interesting thing that's going to pay off later is he's going to be grinding a little bit of ice cream here, and it's fast if he does it well. And he's going to be hitting multiple enemies with Blizzard here to build up the command gauge really fast. He got almost the worst pattern, but he was able to get away with it. Without getting hit, anyway.
The Blizzard hit me only, so...
Yeah. And those guys always spawn when you start off like this, so... There's no, like, chance of them not showing up, and he just got, like, a ton of ingredients for ice cream, which you'll see later.
So, sliding dash is pretty useful in this game for reaching chests that you're not supposed to reach yet. And I'll be doing that now. Unfortunately, the item I get, I just sell it for money anyways. But...
It is used in one fight to deal damage, which is nice, at least.
It is.
But yeah, it's a pretty high-level magic that you're not really supposed to have right away.
Also, one little subtle thing I want to note. Every time he opens the chest, he has to wait around for about a minute before he can open the darn thing. The delay on it's really bad.
On the nice part, though, you're invincible when you're doing it, which is helpful against some enemies. You can't get knocked out of it like in Cage, too.
Okay.
Yeah, so he's coming up on Mr. Unfortunate, which is probably one of the worst fights of the run, because he can do whatever he wants. Bloody came up with a speedrun strat of it where you can put him to sleep constantly.
It's so dark.
Yeah, it is really dark. Yeah, where you can put him to sleep constantly so he doesn't really get a chance to do any attacks, but not everybody has adopted that strat, and some people have a lot of trouble with it. And Bloody's not sure why.
Just a bit too long.
He tried to do something.
This track can be quicker, but it's only when he gives us a certain attack power. So, I go for it.
Yeah, I believe there's a 1 in 4 chance for what he chooses at a certain time,
yeah.
So... There's one really bad pattern with Adam's strat, where if you get it, you automatically have a slow fight.
Looks like our KH community is having fun with Catbag in chat right now.
What dumb thing.
That's all I
see.
Someone
should have made sub emotes for awkward Ben and Terra faces.
There's a Roxas one. They can use that. That's close to Ben. I mean, it's not a happy emote, but Ben's not a happy character. Yeah, so really dumb fight that we unfortunately have to do.
Yeah, you need to knock him down in order to keep him from moving on to his next attack phase. He gets knocked down after taking so many hits. But if you wait too long between attacks, he'll run away from you.
Yeah, so he's going to just try to build up command gauge while staggering him here and get a knockdown and build up more command gauge. The goal is he should be at least in Spellweaver with almost fully charged Spellweaver finisher. So he can get another knockdown, hopefully with a good pattern and kill him. So he already has a finisher. All he has to do is shot lock the correct phase, and then he'll stagger it and go in for hopefully the knockdown kill. Yeah, he had the slide dash in and the catch up to him.
Very nice.
He almost got it right.
The sliding dash was slow.
Yeah, he did it fast and it was still not as fast as it could be, which is like, you don't have really any room to mistake that.
I've got a $20 donation from Shibmeister, also from the KH community. Shib here, just wanted to say great job on the run, Spike and Biz, and good luck to Adam on his run. Glad that Aqua was able to win. Put this towards the MF fight because everyone needs to see the strat for that one.
Yeah, if you guys never seen, most people are used to watching MF be done with surge spam, which is generally the smartest way to do it, but Adam came up with something a little bit more interesting.
Yeah.
Has weird side effects.
Oh God.
Our community is a bunch of children. All right, sorry.
True story. Thank you all for donating.
I've also got a $10 donation. I'm sorry, I'm eating over here while I'm professional. I got a $10 donation from Demon RHK. Lunar 2 bromides because Borgen. Love Demon RHK. Thank you for your donation. I didn't understand it.
It has to be
awesome.
Seen the no.
Oh, You got it. You at home. You who donated. So, thank you for the $10 donation.
So, there are two wards in this game are most likely going to die. This is the first one, because goons.
Yeah. Goons can easily combo or two-shot you, so...
The attacks have a pretty long hitbox duration, and early on... People know Aqua's Cartwheel later in the game is broken, where you can just chain it for permanent invincibility, but at early levels, it has very little iframes, and you can get hit by the goons pretty easily.
Yeah, we have pretty specific strats to try to avoid that, but it just doesn't always work out like that. We're basically going to be doing another shop where I'll explain what he's exactly doing. But there used to be a cure chest here, which we got for safety, but we don't get it anymore because we just assume we're not really going to need it.
I actually won't be equipping a cure spell until the final two bosses.
Yeah, which means we can't really get hit.
Do you want that moved?
This defense is good offense.
The
box.
Just box.
Box.
No, it's not in the way. It's fine.
Okay. Well, low tens are long.
Moving anyway. I want to
see.
It's
kind of interesting watching him practice side by side with Spike and Biz the other day, but they did a synced cutscene skip. It's usually like.
Spike could go through like three screens and then the links could still be going.
Yeah.
Any day now.
Fix this square, please.
Yes. Beta install, please.
So he bottled. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, he basically sold Fisher for a couple other things and then bought like magnets and.
Magnet and file.
Magnet, okay. Oh, and the fires. The magnets are very useful against the goons. You'll see it real quick. Kind of like isolates them so they can't just rush you down. And Bloody found out you can just do this to get
nice.
This chest. Instead of going all the way around.
The issue is... Okay, they didn't follow. Two melee goons can follow you down there and kill you as soon as you land.
Yeah, I saw that happen.
Yeah.
I think it was Dio, actually, in one of the Aqua tournament races. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Made the jump.
You gotta look out for them.
Yeah, in general, have you guys talked about how hard the goons are in this world?
Yeah.
It's pretty tough for the third world in the game. Like, I think even casually people have a lot of trouble with stuff here.
Mm-hmm. The goons are just horrible enemies because of where they're at, and then they give no experience. It's like, I think it's four. With most.
So, a lot of goons here.
Giving
you do
a
not,
lot.
You don't want them swarming you, so he's gotta be really careful not to throw out a magnet if something's about to attack him or he'll be dead. And he wants the finisher to speed up the end, so. He's gotta still keep building up Command Gauge and Spellweaver.
And hope Philip killed the one he's supposed to,
mm-hmm.
and he didn't. I leave one alive and hope Philip kills him, and he barely does.
Yeah.
It's worth them to give it his moment.
Yeah. Half the time, Philip actually just dies to him.
So. Our hero.
Yeah, that's why he's a shield.
I mean, at least in the Dragon Maleficent fight, you want him to die. He can actually do too much damage and mess up the strat. It's pretty rare that it happens, but it just did earlier today. So.
Yeah, it happens to me maybe like one out of five or seven tries, maybe.
I don't have it that much.
I'm lucky.
So here we're going to take out the goons on the walls first because they can snipe you while you're trying to kill the other ones, so just safe way to get rid of them.
Yeah, you generally want to drag them down first and then deal with the ground ones. And like, there are different spawns too, so you have to wipe out a certain like amount of them first in certain groups to get the other last two spawns.
So in the next room, I'm going to go for a trick that Rebelwatt found, affectionately named the Kobe. Because I promised him I would go for it. I hope I don't get it. I know Biz was watching me earlier try to practice it.
It looks impossible. I'm not sure how Rebel ever got it once. You're going to see a really cool movement tech here that was found as well. Are we?
Yeah.
I want to make sure you do it.
Yeah, no, I did.
So not everybody does it.
Nice.
Yep.
It's not difficult at all.
You just lock on and press triangle.
Yeah, so
but
in this next
cool.
room, if I fail the Kobe, I'll be picking up a chest I need later to get the second chance ability. If I get Kobe, I don't get that chest, and I have to hope the item drops. If it doesn't drop, I'll be doing a detour at the end of the game to come back and get this chest.
Oof.
Yeah.
If he threw that magnet out like a frame later, he probably would have got hit or died.
Yeah, not died.
Rebel in chat says, don't fail me.
You need to yell at Rebel Soup about subbing.
Spellweaver just finished a bit short to kill them.
Yeah.
These are the last two enemies
to watch. Yeah, I'm a bit short on experience. So when your allies in this game kill and... Oh, I didn't go for it because I'm talking about experience. Oh, well.
Whoops.
Sorry, Rebel.
Sorry, Rebel.
Go for a Q.
I have to kill these guys. I'll go for the SGDQ, it's fine.
There, I think.
But, yeah, so... God is Exodus expectation. So what the Kobe is when I did that reaction command and landed on that ledge, I then jump off the ledge, shoot a blizzard at that wheel across the screen, and hope that somehow it magically hits.
Yeah, you didn't get it once in practice, right?
No, I got it 3 times. I got it once, and then, like, 20 minutes later, I got it twice in a row.
Oh, was it really? Wasn't there?
I witnessed that.
Yeah,
I
rolled it just
like Oh, okay. Because when I was watching you do it, it
yeah.
didn't look like it.
But, so your commands in this game level up with CP. It's not experience, but when you kill an enemy, you get CP. Commands level up. They need to be a certain level to meld them to make stronger commands. Fun thing is when you're fighting with allies, if your ally kills an enemy, you don't gain the experience or the CP from them dying. So I had to kill a couple extra goons because of Philip killing too many. That can be an issue in the Mickey fight. I've never had it as an issue with the way I've done it, though. So
yeah, the current strat for the Mickey fight is pretty consistent at Mickey not getting kills.
Right now I'm just making stronger versions of Magnet with Magna and Magic Haste, which reduces the amount of time it takes for magic commands to recharge.
This is also somewhat new of a strat. We used to do it differently, but then what was it, Trinity Armor, where
yeah,
I figured out Magnera is actually useful in the fight, even though it doesn't affect him.
Mm-hmm. Just for building up the gauge.
Yeah, like, I accidentally forgot a menu, and then it actually worked still, so now
yeah.
we skip a menu.
So,
heavy mistakes.
So, Dragon Maleficent, fun fight, but a very glaring weakness with him, which I will be abusing.
Yeah, this is a fight,
pretty obvious.
I have a video of it, and a lot of people are like, oh, this is so hard, I can't win this, and now you're gonna watch the easy way to do it.
So you can vote behind her and not get hit by anything.
Why didn't I think of this back in Cage 1?
Why didn't you think of casting Stop?
I'm going to lock on the next time so you can actually see the damage.
Stop doesn't
yeah.
work on bosses.
Yeah, so that's her health now.
So he has to save Ice Barrage until you go into Spellweaver, because it builds a lot of gauge for the finisher.
And I didn't get the bad pattern, so...
Yeah, he got the good luck. If she does the Fire Breath there, she's dead.
Nice!
And he didn't get hit once.
Yeah, it was this boss fight that we first found out how broken level 1 was on Aqua. It's actually not even being level 1, it's just equipping 0 EXP. You can be any level and equip that ability and get this kind of damage. So even playing without being level 1, until you hit about level 35 or 40, it's worth to have this on.
Yes.
I tested damage on one of the final bosses, and it was the equivalent of being level 37 with the Ultima weapon.
1.5 has the same problem. They were smart in 2FM, and it doesn't have any secret properties to it, but in 1.5 in this, they had to try to make it like work awkwardly, and this is the result. Like some... weird strats. If you've ever seen 1.5 Proud, you'll know what is done in that run. That is interesting with the EXP Zero.
2FM solution, just giving you more abilities is probably more fun.
It is. It's more, I thought it was fun, yeah. This game has, like, the flaw of, like, you can get second chance once more, which we get. And a lot of other cage speedruns, you don't get that. So on harder difficulties, you would have trouble if you got hit more than a couple times. For us, we have ways to survive them thanks to those abilities. If we didn't get them, we probably would just die constantly at the end of the game.
So when I first started running level 1, the next boss would occasionally kill me for almost no apparent reason. But I haven't had that happen in a while, so I was hoping. Yeah.
Die?
I think it's only if you don't break them apart soon.
Yeah. actually stayed on the railing.
It's slightly faster movement-wise to go up the railing, but it's kind of, with analoging, be a little tricky keeping yourself straight.
Yeah, PS3 analog stick's very sensitive, so it's hard to keep going exactly straight on it.
This was the fight Adam mentioned that sometimes Mickey can steal CP from you. There was an old strat where you would actually Magnera those mandrakes back there at the bottom of the stairs, but Adam don't live that life.
It's a safety strat. You can still do it, but most people just say whatever.
Yeah. And you can complain about the PS3 analog stick, but running this game on a PSP for 2 years, I'd never go back.
Oh, yeah.
That analog nub.
So he magnets them all immediately and can like instantly build drive by a command gauge by attacking them while they're in the magnet. And then that ice barrage kills them all in the magnet.
Mickey killing a flood is fine.
So now he's got all the birds caught and can just easily kill them. And he got fire level 2, so now he doesn't need to worry about that. So now he can meld them together.
Is get my fourth magic haste. There's a chance to get a fifth magic haste, but it relies on getting a fleeting crystal drop, which doesn't happen very often. You don't kill many enemies that can drop one.
More often than not, we don't get it. Like you said, you wouldn't usually even bother checking it.
Yeah, in normal runs I wouldn't check, in this one I will.
Yeah. It's a very slight benefit, it's nothing like crazy.
It helps in the OC rounds, and that's about it.
Yeah. So he's going to get Fire Rod and attach a Fleeting Crystal to get Magic Haste, because the more you have of those, the faster your magic commands will reload, and that helps a lot, because, you know, Aqua's pretty much all magic-based, so as you can see, they're already loading faster, so they could be used really frequently in fights because of that. And he also picked up Mind Square, because that's used a decent amount of these days in the current strats.
Yeah, it does okay damage, but it's really good at filling up the command gauge, especially when you're already in spell reform.
Yeah.
Because after this fight, I'm going to unlock a new command style called Blade Charge. It essentially means that whenever I enter spell reform, I can't use any ice or fire based magic commands, or I will get Blade Charge instead of the spell reform finisher, which does not do nearly as much damage.
Mm.
So my half of my commands right now are ice and fire based, so Mind Square gives me a good alternative to use.
Yeah, you'll see what he means after this fight, most likely.
Hopefully you'll never see Blade Charge.
Oh. It can lead to deaths if you get Blade Charge, because it has wide range, and it does hit pretty hard, but it's just not nearly as good as Spellweaver, and we kind of rely on Spellweaver to kill a lot of stuff.
I also didn't move to Ice Barrage after Daylight for a second.
He opens this fight with the Ice Barrage to hopefully immediately get Spellweaver by targeting the leg.
It didn't lock on to begin. Yeah. The lock-on system in this game can be really finicky. I have to do the straight strat now because of that.
Yeah, so he's still going to be able to get the finisher just fine. He might have a little trouble quickly trying to build up another Spellweaver, though, is the only issue here.
Yeah, I'm going to have to deal with the laser, which I'm not used to having to do. Oh no, it's laser gun. I'm fine.
So he's good at this point. So this is back on track. He's going to double damage these guys, and when that one dies, this one's going to do an invincible attack.
Yeah, he's invincible while swimming blazers. I try to position myself somewhat behind the other two so they take the hits for me. Because it's not guaranteed that you're going to go with them.
Yeah, it's pretty silly that you could just stand right under him and he can't touch you.
Oh, yeah. The issue is some spells do have a form of knockback when you cast them. So I do have to be careful that I don't accidentally push myself back into the laser, because it is a one-shot.
Yeah. A lot of people had trouble learning where to stand, but you get used to it pretty fast, where you're like, oh, okay, I'm safe. So that fight usually can be tough for a lot of people, but that you made it look trivial.
As long as you kill him before he uses the laser the first time, because with level 1, level 2 cartwheel at this point, it's really easy to die to that.
Yeah.
If you don't time it really well.
What?
Not in this one.
I've got a $5 donation from Gnome. Grats to Adam for having his run raise nearly $5,000 on the bid war alone. It's sad that we don't get to see Ben percent. I heard Adam practiced it a lot. Kappa.
Thank God that Kappa.
I pra- practiced it more than Terra. Say that.
Let's not say how many times then.
So, next boss. A lot of people go through Kingdom Hearts games without ever trying to put status effects on bosses. A big eye-opener for this in like H1 speedruns is Stop on Dragon Maleficent. This comes into play with Vanitas in the next fight. He is vulnerable to most status effects in this first fight.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting because normally Vanitas is an extremely poorly designed fight. They actually designed them. This game doesn't really do revenge values the way KH2 does, and their version of this is like have a boss that randomly can break out of any hit, so we have to try to get around that. And the way he's going to do it is going to get around him breaking out every hit. And look, he can break out of the first attempt. So.
Yeah, I start off the fight with magic and hope it hits. If not, I just need to use the second one.
Yeah.
Because he does have a random chance to just any attack you use on him to miss.
Yeah, you can really never successfully, consistently combo Vanitas. He can break out at any time, which is a little unfortunate. But we have this strat you're about
to see.
It's
a much bigger factor the next time you fight him.
Yeah. A lot of people enjoy this fight because of what you do.
So he is not going to be leaving that spot.
So now he's in Spellweaver, but because he has Blade Charge, he doesn't want to use any Fire or Blizzard until the finisher is queued up, or else he'll get Blade Charge instead of the finisher.
Yep.
So he has to poke him with physicals.
Now once you have the finisher ready, though, you can't get Blade Charge, and I can just use all my commands.
That's nice. He just doesn't know what to do.
Killed by Spellweaver itself.
Yeah, do you want to explain why we hold on to Spellweaver instead of just using it as soon as we get it?
Because we want it to kill him, because if not, if we use it improperly, he won't die to it, and then we'll have to come up with some other way to kill him, like right there.
Yeah, that's about the max damage you can do with Spellweaver, so if you use it early in the fight, it ends, Magnet has ran out, and so he breaks away, and then you have to catch him in Magnet again and start the cycle level, so it's better to just hold on to Spellweaver when it can kill him.
There's a couple other instances where we hold on the Spellweaver a little bit to make sure we use it at the right time.
I will say the one big appeal to the Vin run is that it has a similar strat to that. The first time you fight Vanitas on Vin, except you use Sleep instead of Magna, and you just let Mickey kill him.
That is just as silly as it sounds.
Yeah.
So, do you want to explain why we don't go to Disney Town? Because every other category for this game would go to Disney Town after Radiant Garden.
We don't really... We have to... Is it a spoiler?
Yeah, just... You can say why.
Ice cream.
Yeah.
That's why. You'll see.
We have to say.
You don't want to... Okay, we can just explain it when we get there, since we need something to do during Super Bowl.
We would have to go back, basically, if we did it now.
Yeah, okay. We can just have plenty of time during Super Bowl, I guess.
Yeah, that's huge dead time in there. So we're going to Deep Space first, and this world has probably the worst part of the run easily. Most of us agree.
Yeah, there's a mini game coming up after this battle. I will be playing the mini game pretty safe, so hopefully I don't die.
The funny part is playing it safe, you still can get killed at random.
Long, boring, and incredibly lethal.
And you don't hold on to
it. It makes it exciting that it's lethal, though.
I mean, exciting's a word unless you're wanting to go for a PB.
Yeah.
Tell that to Cyborg. Yeah, so one of the runners, Cyborg, he does not take that fight safe whatsoever, and most of his runs would die then.
Yeah. You have a very low percentage of getting through it successfully if you YOLO the fight.
Yeah, so I only equipped Ice Barrage before that fight because I need to level up 2 more fires, and Ice Barrage is useless in that fight anyways, so that's the only fight up until we get Ice Cream that I don't have it equipped. And now I have to see if I had luck with getting that last Magic Haste. There was a chance that I'd still get it on that mode. When you mode a command without any any crits or equips to it, it has a random chance of getting any ability that that command can attain. So there is a very small chance that I could still get magic haste on it. I've had it happen twice.
We can actually get Leaf Bracer from that too, and I've gotten that before in a run, and it's pretty funny.
Sounds nice.
Leaf Bracer used to be part of the route, but we got rid of it because you need the same crystal to get Leaf Bracer and Second Chance, and you can only guarantee yourself getting one of those two.
Yeah.
So Second Chance is more important, so we get that.
We just also decided that Leaf Bracer just isn't necessary. We shouldn't be really needing it, because we only use Cure for two fights now.
Although Leaf Bracer would be nice in the final boss.
Yeah. We can talk about that more later.
Yeah, it's not necessary. So, this minigame, I'm just going to stand on at the edge and let them come to me. If I stand anywhere else, I have blind spots and they can hit me. I die in three single hits, but any combo hit between any of them can kill me.
Yeah, we call this Take That Gotcha.
And
wow.
That happens. This is why everyone hates this minigame.
And there's nothing you could have done to safely survive that either.
They
just chose to kill us.
Shout out to that retry button that they added between
yeah.
Cage 2.
Oh, please.
Yes.
That's about as fast as the death as you can have in this, so it's not a big deal. Oh my
god. Golly, are you kidding
wow.
me?
Just gonna probably die anyways. So this is the safe shot for this fight.
Yep.
This fight is...
I've tried to develop a safer strat where you maybe wait for the first one to attack you if it comes at you, but that doesn't guarantee another one
okay,
won't come
I
right
didn't
now.
Die immediately.
Yeah, so now he's going
to
be pretty
close.
Chilling. Yeah, he's going
to
be chilling
see... Playing on somewhat of a small TV, and it's hard to tell if any of them are charging up in the background. Because I'm waiting for them to charge at me and then hit them. I'll do this until there's about a third of them left, and then I'll leave this wall.
Definitely the best minigame ever.
Oh, so gotcha, take that.
This is pretty good damage, though.
Yeah, I don't think this minigame is affected by your level at all.
I don't think so, because the other attacks do, no damage.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Ven's minigame isn't affected by... I know Ven's isn't affected by strength.
The good thing about this fight is the HP orbs that are dropped by the enemies, picking up a single one will completely refill his health.
I don't like being in the middle.
Yeah. That's in. Imagine someone who tries to do the whole fight in the middle. Where you can just get hit from behind at random and die.
I also say I hate playing any kind of shooters. I don't play them at all.
Hey, it's over. Congrats on over.
So we consider that the worst part of the run, easily.
Yeah.
And now it gets a little bit more relaxing until a couple worlds.
Yeah. I also won't be doing the boss fights for either this world or OC until a bit later. I'm going to get up until the boss fight and then move on for now. Also, D-Link loads. 2.5 load times.
So those enemies are pretty terrifying. They can pretty much kill you in a combo immediately, so we don't want to keep them stuck in magnet whenever they're close.
Fine. There's only two, so that one's okay.
Yeah.
It's the next group that's dangerous.
That's why we want to be safe with them a bit. We have to clear out this room because we need to go into the center and use the reaction command, so everything has to be killed.
It's the only reaction command in the game that is affected by enemies on screen.
Wow.
They force you to kill everything, because all the other ones, like opening chests and such, you can do with enemies.
Yeah. That's so weird. Yeah, a lot of people died at that fight, too, after getting past the bike minigame.
Yeah. I just walk up to those two, because it's only two, they will never kill you. It's the groups of three that were one shot.
Yeah. I go more towards the center, because I try a weird magnet mindscore shred.
Yeah.
Also to note, Adam, Gnome's $5 donation from earlier was actually for your choice.
I was going to say, since Voligin met those, I don't know what to put them to. So.
Yeah. Do you want to just look after the run?
Yeah,
afterwards.
Why don't you remind us of a couple of things later,
Sure. Let's look at some of the stuff we got coming up, since generously you guys donated for all of the Kingdom Hearts stuff. So, once again, thank you all for that. Coming up right after this is Final Fantasy VI, and there's tons and tons, I'm scrolling. There's tons of things you can donate for. There's, of course, all of the naming incentives. You can name Cyan, Edgar, Gal, Locke, let's see here, Realm, Satan, Setzer, Terra.
Another Terra.
Yeah. Another Terra. Terra's just all over today. Welcome to the Terra block.
So these two bot enemies, they like to teleport, and they have invincibility from when, as soon as their teleport begins until a few seconds after it ends. And I got really unlucky with one of them teleporting away from me during that Spellweaver.
Mm-hmm.
Normally you finish a fight with the Spellweaver, but he teleported away and I had to chase him.
To, I guess, give you guys an update on some of the donation incentives and bidding wars for those. The character palette swaps, we currently have $50 out of 200 for that. I'm assuming we don't need that until we get to Kefka's Tower, but getting your donations for that. For the Cyan name right now, it is Cherry at $10, Stash at $1. For Edgar, I've got $12 for Kantala and $8 for Kutan, all capital. Gal, I've got FF Gamer at $60, Tundra at $1. Locke, I've got Enki Me at $10.
And then 2.5. So, you notice the game lagged there for a moment. That happens to every person who's run this game, any version of this game on 2.5, English or Japanese. So,
we don't know why.
Yeah.
So, more ice cream farming, because we're going to be needing to buy ice cream, and we need certain items for the rest of these.
And I guess during this part, I can explain. Back in that previous fight, you know, after the minigame, I used that Magna, and it went into the D-Link load animation. That happens when you use a command before the game has fully loaded it. It forces you into that while it's loading the command. On the PSP version, it was still possible, but it was pretty rare to happen. On 2.5, it pretty much happens any time you use a command after a cutscene, because the game is slow at loading pretty much anything.
We don't know how that's even possible. It's just a command. How much does it need to load?
It's like within 3 seconds of skipping a cutscene, it would do that animation. It needs about that long to load everything. But I've had a lot of people ask me about that, because they've had it happen. Normally, you would only see that animation with a D-Link. So.
Yeah, a lot of people think it's like random, but it's not. It's like it's actually predictable.
So, this fight, Hercules is one of the best allies because he's completely negligible. He doesn't help or hurt this fight at all.
There is a slim chance that then he could pull away an enemy, maybe if one of the floods doesn't get caught in Magnet, but that's not common.
Like, basically every guest character in Cage 2.
Yeah. This is a pretty long fight, too, for a mob fight. So he's gonna actually build up 2 Spellweavers. He wanted to save him for those 3 big guys, because they can kill you pretty easy. And they also have a decent amount of HP.
Yeah. Too late for that to be useful.
I know, right? So that was that's generally how the fight should go. Mm-hmm.
Also, I guess since Cartwheel leveled up, I should mention that I won't be maxing out Cartwheel. It's once Cartwheel is level 4 that you can chain it together for invincibility. I will be finishing the game at level 3, so I can still easily get sniped out of Cartwheel. Mm. So, against the final bosses, I will be trying to not Cartwheel as much as possible, so that that doesn't happen.
Yeah, like, you're not fully invincible during Cartwheel level 3 or like 4, so you can't just sit there and spam it.
I don't think it was until running level 1 crit that I realized it. Higher levels on Cartwheel gave invincibility, because on beginner that really didn't matter.
Yeah, I didn't notice it right away either. Because usually you max it out before endgame where it really matters anyway.
So, in the Colosseum, I won't be using any Spellweaver finishers until the final round, because a round will not end until you are done with any battle animations. So if I use a Spellweaver, I have to wait until that runs out for the next round to go on. And each round only has 1 wave of enemies, so it's not worth using it.
We also need it for the last round, so that we don't die instantly.
Those jellies are numerous and will kill you.
Yeah.
If you're not prepared for the last round, you will get swarmed by the jellies and die.
Yeah. So we want to hold on to this. And just and before he built up Spellweaver, he had to make sure not to use Fire or Blizzard, but now he can go crazy because he has Spellweaver finisher. So most rounds are going to die to a Magnera and Ice Barrage, maybe two Magneras or a Mindsphere instead could be subbed in, stuff like that.
I only use Mindsphere for round two, otherwise it's just Magnera.
Yeah. I usually, some of them I'll double Magnera just to be sure.
I'm also going to guard at the beginning of this because if all three Mandrakes charge like that, it will kill you. If there's only one or two charging, you can get away with tanking the hit, but with all three, you'll die.
If you get double the Bounding Crystal.
I may have gotten three by now, I don't know. You have a higher chance to get them once you hit OC. It's not 5% like in Radiant Garden.
Yeah.
I'm used to seeing them drop, you know, double pulsing. I'm getting so many crystals that I don't need. Maybe I should have ran Vin. Because the biggest bright side for me with Aqua is that you don't have drop luck. With almost every other category for this game, you for an optimal run, you need good luck with getting certain drops from enemies. And with Aqua, that's not an issue. We get everything we need from chests.
Yeah, like you can skip some of the chests and hope for the drops, but usually they're like almost right in your path anyway, so there's no reason really, unless you want to reset your run like halfway through for drop luck.
like last week, I did 3 Vin runs and 2 Terra runs for practice. Optimal runs needed a total of 21 crystal drops, and altogether I got 5.
This is why we wanted Aqua to win.
And not getting a single Shimmering Crystal can make you lose upwards of a minute in damage on the final bosses. So they can be rather important. Ice cream?
Oh yeah, you need to get ice cream.
Aren't your PBs and both of those still your first runs?
My Ven run for 2.5, my current PB for Ven is still the first run I did because I got, I think, perfect crystal luck. It's not a good run, it just had really good luck. Terra, I beat that last week, finally.
This is the last ice cream he has to grab. Now we have the ability to buy a specific recipe of ice cream.
Also, it's not guaranteed that I'm getting enough ingredients. Each time I'm killing these enemies, they drop one of three ingredients that changes constantly while you're attacking them. I need one specific type from each of those three spawns I've done, so hopefully I get enough for the one I need. It's impossible to judge which one you're getting.
Adam did a lot of testing with ice cream to realize we don't need to go crazy on farming them. We don't need to use, like, a full Spellweaver finisher like we used to. We can kind of, like, go away from it. Okay, so this is a pretty big menu. He has to sell a bunch of stuff, buy a bunch of stuff. He's buying a bunch of Ignites. He's buying the Suna Barrier, which will be melded. And he sold like, the Magneras and Ice Barrage, because we don't really need them anymore.
From this point out, anything I fight is a boss.
Yep, boss rush. Well, and a minigame.
Minigame, then boss
rush. And one glorious minigame.
A very, very special minigame.
Yeah, so yes. I'm hoping to see, like, around 36 to 40 ice cream from this shop. We used to grind 99 just because we didn't know how much ingredients we needed. We just got as much to ensure that there was enough. If I don't die to the final bosses, I should be fine with around 30.
Do you do the minigame first or the menu?
Menu. Okay. The minigame takes 2 hours, so you have to do it first.
Oh, right. Well, I think... So, yeah. Some people do the menu, like, in the next one.
Oh, in OC,
yeah.
No, I just do it here.
I think... I forgot if Bloody does that. I think he does.
There's no reason to wait, so I just get out of there. And I got enough.
54?
Yeah.
Like, I think that if you want to be really risky, you can get as low as 30 and be okay.
So, 10% chance that this turns into a Raging Storm and I'm going to be annoyed.
Awesome. Alright, so now he has once more once he equips that Faranga. So, just like in our 2FM run, that means combo attacks can't kill us. But he's also going to get a second chance, so single hits can't kill us. So now he can survive.
As long as I'm not at one health, I should live. There are some instances where that's not true. Particularly final boss, because his attacks will go through the barrier. So 3-minute mini game.
I hope you have like 30 donations to read.
Take it away.
Yeah, this is just a mini game in which.
That's all the commentary we need during this mini game.
Just a monster roar.
That's coming up for a specific boss. Because, you'll notice I bought 5, but I only equip 1. I need 1 for the next boss, but 1 coming up, Spellweaver isn't a viable strat on him until near the end, so we're getting Mike's for it. We'll go into more detail when we get to it.
Fruit Ball's a fun game.
It's
yeah.
I'll take a level ice cream. It's a nice break.
I would like to announce this is a major moment in RPG Limit Break history. The world record holder of Fruit Ball is sitting right here, holding the controller, in fact.
Two known times, and I'm not second place. Or two known scores.
What an honor. The world record, you got at what, like 43 or something?
Yeah. Me and one other runner are the only people who have ever cared about getting a decent score in this. And Rebel is in second with, I think, 40 or 41. And I have 43. But you can just get up to like 15 points and you're good.
Is it okay if I go?
Yeah, go ahead.
Alright, who's hungry?
It's Google.
In 30 minutes, I will be.
So we brought some appropriate.
I wondered if you guys were going to do that.
Oh, baby. Wow,
yeah. I'll save the
just get banana.
I'll
okay,
save
sure,
the next
I'll
apple.
Right
up, I'll save the next banana. That's
you also
lunch
got
for
some
you.
Apples and some. Well,
I'm just gonna hold on to this banana then. See if I can carry it through to the end.
Would you like one real banana?
No,
we can hold it for you.
I'm good with.
Are you having as much trouble with this as
apple,
I am?
Apple, apple,
anyone?
I hit it.
It's impossible.
That was the hardest banana I've ever.
I know. Okay, okay.
Yeah! Right. We have achieved banana. Alright.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so once you get like 10, 15 points, you can just pick
up the tool. Just rip it out of the side.
I'm afraid we're falling out.
I like to mess around to see how long I can go without touching the ground.
Oh, did you lose my banana?
There's some way here.
Oh, okay, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's not the same one.
Does that qualify as a banana?
I mean, there's banana peels now.
Yeah, like, you don't need a high score to be safe here, really. Like, 15 plus is pretty safe.
You can end at 15 and sometimes have 20 points when you come back because they will score on themselves.
Yeah. They're pretty good at bouncing off the nets back into their own goals.
Also, so now I've got a $20 donation donated anonymously, so maybe you know this person, Biz. I don't know. Hey, Biz and Adam, good luck on the run. Thank you for running this game today. As for a donation incentive, you guys can pick. P.S. Biz, it's the 4-month anniversary of me being a sub to you, and it happens to be my birthday. So it looks like I'm giving you $5 for my birthday. OPOP.
Unfortunately, I don't think I can remember the monthly anniversaries for everybody, but thank
you. This
happy
guy.
Birthday.
I have thousands of subs.
I have billions.
Okay, so that's over with. And now we're done now we're done with Disney Town.
I have to stop eating the banana now.
On the bright side, this
just
is
finish
the,
it off during the loading screen.
Yeah. On the bright side, this is one of the only runs where Disney Town has more of a use than just playing a mini game, because we do get the ice cream there as well, which is why Disney Town is done.
Did
so
we explain
late.
Ice cream yet?
I don't think so. We're about to find out.
Yeah, it's cool. Yeah.
Okay.
You're seeing the Zach fight what ice cream does. I have it equipped. It's the item called Fabricadabra.
How close to a new world record at Fruit Ball were we today?
I wasn't watching.
At all. Yeah. Like
I stopped caring. Like
I only even got half of a world record. Yeah. We are so disappointed in you. I also want to remind you guys, as he's about to go into these fights, that, again, you can still, if you donate a minimum of $10 throughout the rest of this Kingdom Hearts block, which you got about 15 minutes left, then you're entered into a drawing for the Keyblade necklace, the Roxas pendant, and the Sora pendant.
Hmm. Well, alright. So, he wants to open this fight with Ignite, because Ignite deals consistent damage over time until it stops, and that helps us kill him with Spellweaver. We're going to have to Ignite him twice, and then we can kill him in two Spellweavers. Mm-hmm. But we have to be careful, because he can attack us in between ice cream. Alright, so he should be safe to get that finisher. And this is why ice cream is good.
Yeah, so using ice cream once puts you into a command style. Using the same type again gives you the finisher. I got hit by the shockwave, though, so it didn't get me down in one. So, yeah, this is how we fight bosses for the rest of the game.
Well, Zigball.
Except for... Zigball. I have a treat for Zigball.
Burrito Man.
If you thought Peter Pan was good in the previous game, you'll enjoy Zigball. Brig. I know it's Brig. You got me saying Zigball.
I know. I was like wondering why you were saying Zigball.
You said it.
I corrected myself.
Thank you. Okay, so Hades has four different movement patterns that he'll open this fight with. He'll either move away from me to the left or right, or towards me to the left or right. I want him to move away from me. assume. Whenever we like. I can explain the entire box.
That is a long load screen.
Loading the Ice Colossus in Hades fight is one of the longest load screens in the game. I can explain the entire strat doing it.
Yeah, so if he gets good luck, he'll get a DM skip here, which is nice.
Yeah, I want Hades to move away from me towards the Colossus.
Mm-hmm. And it's possible to try to poke Hades if he doesn't to make a move there, but it's random if he decides to.
Yeah, I want to move next to the Colossus because then Spellweaver can hit both Hades and the Colossus at the same time instead of having to fight them separately, which I'll have to do if Hades moves away. And nope.
The best of
hopefully this
ball.
Hits him back.
One instance of Hades was not enough today.
Yeah, see, he hit him, so he decided to go another way, and it was a good pattern.
It doesn't always work, though. Sometimes he'll continue moving that way.
Yeah.
Back here, Hades.
So he baited out his attack, so he'll be able to hopefully kill him in the next Spellweaver, so he doesn't DM.
He's so quiet compared to KJ Hades, too.
So now it should be a good fight. Oh,
killed
wow.
Very
nice.
Yeah.
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 Colossus kills really good.
At the same exact time.
I actually just learned while practicing this a few days ago that Hades has a specific line of dialogue that I hadn't heard for 2 years. It's if Hades is DMing and the Ice Colossus tries to hurt Hades, he has a line of dialogue for that. He says somebody needs to chill out. Two and a half years of running this game, I hadn't heard that line. And I've been running, when I started running BVS, period, my first category was Aqua Beginner. So I've been fighting Hades for that whole time.
I've never heard it, and I've been running this, or I ran it for like a couple months, so it's very uncommon, apparently. So now we're returning the deep space to kill Gantu.
So Gantu has a bit of luck involved with Stitch. Stitch is an ally in that fight. I need him to do... Like, I need him to only hit Gantu once or twice, and it's enough for him to die in 2 Spellweavers. If the second Spellweaver doesn't kill him, then it means Stitch was useless.
There's also a slim chance we could die on this if we're really unlucky, because we're wide open after Spellweaver. We don't have iframes to dodge after, so he can dash at us and hit us, and if we're at, like, 1 HP, we're dead.
Yeah, that's the riskiest part of the Spellweaver strat with any of these boss fights is... After Spellweave was done, you are completely vulnerable for a couple of seconds. You can't dodge or guard or anything.
Mm-hmm.
And so second chance and once more very necessary for finishing the game. I've tried to do the game without them. It took a while. A lot of deaths.
Yeah, I think they intend you to get second chance once more, like, somewhere mid-game. Because you can grind out a lot of abilities really early in the game.
Yeah, final bosses, you're fully intended to have most of the health or support abilities like those.
Yeah, it's different than KH2, where they don't usually expect you to have both of them endgame.
So yeah, Gantu, as long as... I can usually heal if Stitch is attacking him, but if Stitch is just completely quiet, it means he's not doing anything.
Yeah, so he's going to run up to him and hit him with a poison to deal some damage before the Spellweaver.
Yeah, it's like the Zac strat where we need to do some damage. However, he's immune to Ignite, which is a stronger version of poison, so we're stuck using poison instead.
Which is a shame, because it's the only real time we use it now in this point, really. So he was nice and dashed early, so... But then that happens.
It's fine. He's dead anyways.
Yeah.
Stitch hit him.
Yeah,
he can take one hit. It's not an
issue. The risky thing is if he didn't kill him here and he dashed, he'd be dead.
Stitch was a bro.
And we don't have access to healing here, so other than like renewal.
Yeah, we made renewal burial, the command that has second chance equipped to it. It's burial, but whenever I guard something, I gain health back. So that is my main source of healing for the game.
And he might be using that a lot on the next Vanitas fight too, if he gets it, because you can kind of predictably know when to guard.
Typically, if you just stand next to him, you bait out his physical attacks. Vanitas does have one move, though, that does go through your guard, Dark Thundiga. So if you try to guard when there's a decent amount of space between you and him, he'll typically use that and kill you instead.
Yeah.
So Neverland is a fun road, because you run around in a circle and then fight a boss.
Yeah, I think you said last night, both Ventus and Terra actually have other mob fights that are in this world, whereas Aqua's just straight to the boss.
Those mob fights are especially inconvenient because of the monkeys that aren't affected by magnet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the boss fight takes place in the room that I'll be standing at when this load screen finishes.
Literally
it's,
a circle.
This world actually has a lot of like movement tech that we've been working on with sliding dash and stuff, so I don't know how much you have been keeping up to date.
That is one pretty cool
that.
Thing about this game, that just some little movement tech that some of which has like a decent skill cap to it.
Yeah. As much as we like KH2 as a speed game, it doesn't really have movement tech to it much. It's mostly just hold forward, get to the next screen. It's about boss optimization. Mm-hmm. However, Birth by Sleep is probably the best KH game as far as just movement tech is.
3D has decent in that as well because of the motion.
Well, there's some movement in 1.5, but platforming in that game is pretty silly.
Trash.
Waterfall Cavern.
And sliding dash and a lot of platforming.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Waterfall Cavern's a nightmare.
Yeah.
That was a long one screen.
Yeah. You get used to them. It made it worse watching Spike playing next to me while practicing.
I'm so sorry.
2FM loads like absurdly fast on PS2 compared to 2.5 BBS. So.
I mean, 2FM loads faster by about 20 minutes over just two KH2 English. So seeing that next to a modern like PS3 Kingdom Hearts port, yeah.
Bad install.
Or, you know, online, but. That wouldn't happen.
No.
Can't buy a single Kingdom Hearts game digitally.
That's really unfortunate. That was one of the biggest problems with 2.5 is just the load time. So that would have been fixed with some kind of like data install or digital purchasing or something.
Okay. So like at the jump right there at the end would normally take you up high, but you use an attack to stop your momentum and click on.
And there he kind of like high jumped and clipped onto the platform because of the when you jump into platforms like that, you kind of gain a little bit of height. So,
it's a bit too far back.
Stuff like that exists even in KH2, when you can like glide in the buildings and gain height from them and like be Hollow Bastion outside your Runzos. Stuff like that. He's gonna change his menu now to prepare for the Vanitas fight, and you can probably guess how it's gonna go based on what he did there.
Yeah, so Vanitas 2 is like Vanitas 1, except he's now immune to Magnet, so you can't keep him stuck in one spot. However, there is one ability he uses that keeps him from dodging Spellweaver. Like, if you try to use Spellweaver normally, you'll hit him about 3 times and he'll teleport away from you. Then you have to chase him down, so you don't do any damage with Spellweaver. So, he has a move where he'll dive underground and come back up. He uses it after he's hit 10 times. I want to get him to the point where he's had enough damage taken that on the 10th hit, he'll dive and the Spellweaver will kill him. If I'm unlucky, he'll live with a bit of health, and I have to try to finish him off afterwards.
Yeah, just like we said earlier with Vanitas 1, he can break out of any hit, and that includes Ignite. So we could be sitting here like spamming Ignites, and he can dodge every single
Ignite
one.
Ignite is a lock-on insta-cast spell, and he can dodge it.
Yeah, it's a bit silly, but...
I want to explain why I'm using Favas at the beginning.
He wants to go into Spellweaver and get the finisher right away because you don't want to mix up Ignites and Fabris because then you can get Blade Charge. So as he hit it once and he has to keep track of how many hits he's getting so he knows when how well to stall it and when the last one is going to make him dive. And because he has Renewal Barrier, it's okay if he tanks a hit, he can just guard the next hit.
It used to be the case that you had to dive it with RNG, how much damage you would do, but there have since been Strass discovery where you can like hit him with a trail of Spellweaver and get consistent damage.
So he's getting pretty close to the point where he'll die once he dives.
Yeah. I want to get him to about one bar of health on the dive.
Alright, so now he's going to do a trick where he won't let him come above ground. And it's still hitting him.
So, when Vanitas dives underground, he'll pop up once and then either be done or he'll go down and back up one or two more times. If he dives 2 or 3 times, you could just stand there and kill him, but if he only dives once, then it doesn't last long enough and he'll break away before Spellweaver kills. So we do the trick to keep him underground.
It was a huge problem originally when we would try to do Spellweaver and he would dive only once and then break out of the end of it, but now we have a way to.
They're pretty good at timing that during load times.
Yeah. They know exactly when to go. It's too gripping.
So now we only have two more fights in the game, and it's going to take a little bit to get to it, so if there's anything else.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, one thing. I will say, I want to show off a strat on the next boss. I will die multiple times to show it off if I need to, because it's...
It is pretty cool.
Yeah. Plexo gives me permission to do it, so I'm doing it.
Oh, are you still doing it?
Well, if we get into, like, it's, like... 10 attempts or more,
okay,
you might have to have a talk.
Yeah, it's inconsistent for me. Like, I can set it up the same way every single time, and it won't always work, so...
Just do it first try, it's fine.
Yeah.
You got
it. Yeah. We don't do it in runs normally, because it's not consistent at all.
Yeah. And it would only save a few seconds. Yeah, good.
Yeah. Well, it gets to save, like, 10 off of, like, a decent regular strat, right?
Yeah, let's just remind you guys that you are watching RPG Limit Break 2015. We're all coming together, members of Speed Demos Archive, Speedruns Live, just a big hodgepodge of us coming together from all sorts of countries to beat 33 of your favorite RPGs and Demon Rush as fast as we can. Right now, we are sadly almost at the end of Kingdom Hearts block for us. But afterwards, don't feel sad, because coming up, we have got Final Fantasy VI after this. There are more donation incentives that I could possibly get to. Make sure to go check those out. Again, things you can donate on. You've got all sorts of different character names. You can determine during FF6 opera, you can donate to see who's going to sing the Draco, Maria, Reyes, and even the Ultros parts. So lots of cool stuff there. The train suplex, which is already met. The merchant lock rides, a chocobo donation incentive needs a lot of help. Character palette swaps.
Yeah, it's special.
There's also a pretty darn good bid war going right now for the menu background. If you want RPG good taste, that's it right now at $255. At RPG Jerkbird, that's not far behind, at $237. We can make this the next Bentis versus Aqua. I never thought I'd say that. But yeah, if you guys want to get in on that, there are tons and tons of incentives. If you are on our Twitch page, I recommend just looking below the stream. The donation tracker will be on your left somewhere down there. And click on it, and you guys can go check out all the bid wars, everything you could donate towards, and also what kind of awesome prizes you can get into the bids for. Again, Kingdom Hearts block is almost over, and once that is over, we will just about be done with a few prizes that you can donate on. If you donate a minimum of $10 by the end of this run, you will be entered into a drawing for the Keyblade Necklace, the Roxas Pendant, and the Sora Pendant.
Okay, so coming up, I'm going to use the only D-Link of the run, or Dimensional Link. In a normal run, I wouldn't use any, but the Peter Pan D-Link is the strongest single-target ability in the game on level 1.
If it works, I believe it's the second best damage per second thing in the entire series. I think Drez corrected me and told me like Daze has something that's even better. But
okay. In BBS, it's by far the strongest ability.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, we just got it from Neverland, so you only have it for the final world, which is why we haven't been using it.
Run killer room if you make a mistake. A lot of people know notoriously that these tornadoes follow you really fast and will catch up to you, but what he's doing is like barely clipping past them, because only one can follow you at a time. And if you keep clipping past them, it just kind of like staggers behind.
It resets which one's following you.
Yeah, like it just keeps falling farther behind, so he has enough time to outrun the first tornado that was following him.
I use sliding dashes because it's quick. Well, you can get through that without any sort of sliding dash or anything.
Yeah, and you don't want to run into those tornadoes, because they take a long time to kill with this setup, and it takes a while to die sometimes,
yeah,
too.
Each tornado is three waves of enemies, so you want to just die, and some enemies, especially the floods, which are beginning enemies, they just sit there and don't attack you.
Fortunately, it's not a really hard trick or something.
Yeah. So, Peter Pan D-Link specifically is what I'll be using against Wig. Each D-Link has their own special condition for filling the command gauge, such as Pete does by collecting money. I think it's either Cinderella or Snow White that's by being afflicted with a status condition. Peter Pan, his fills up by attacking an enemy while you're in the air. And unfortunately, there's only one part of Wake's pattern where he's in the air for that to work. And so, hopefully I can fill up the D-Link while he's in the air. If it doesn't, I might need to take a death.
If he gets unlucky and Brig teleports away in the air after one hit, like, multiple times, he's not going to have a full bar, and then he can't get the Peter Pan strat.
Mm-hmm. So, normal strat for the beginning of this fight would be to cartwheel from his dashes, but since I only have level 3 cartwheel, I don't want to risk taking a hit, so I'm just going to jump over him instead.
Yeah, the normal strat is just a spam Spellweaver when you get the openings, but this is, if it works, a cooler looking strat and faster. That hit was intentional, that usually happens.
Yeah. And he gave me the Vipadon to kill him with Pedo, so it's fine.
So yeah, he's gonna get a ton of damage here, and hopefully he doesn't go up in the air too fast. Okay. So now he's gonna hope to get a full combo at least.
Teleporting to the same spot,
yeah. That's fine.
I think I can get that. Oh, I'm just a bit sure. Yeah, I need to take it there. That honestly looked like it was 4 to me.
Yeah, it did to me too. Yeah.
The TV is really small. So yeah, I need to just take the death and try again. If he teleports away from me after just single hits, it's really hard to get that.
Yeah, he got lucky once, but after that he kept teleporting right away. And this is why we don't do the strat and runs usually, is because that can happen. And he could have tried to back up or he just spam more Spellweaver, but...
I want to show Pedo.
Yeah. This look, though.
I think I can still make that work, because this is full space.
Oh,
so
right,
I can
okay.
still attack him. Okay. That's good.
Now he just has to hope the actual sword build ability actually does what it's supposed to do.
Yeah, even though I have it full, it's not guaranteed this is going to do the damage it's supposed to. It's supposed to do a bit more than that. I got. If you get the bad number of hits, you can pause it and unpause it to make it do. Try to do the right amount of damage. Yeah. We equipped Double Fight to hit him during the DM with Spellweaver, but with Pedo Pan, it's really hard to fit that in.
Yeah. He didn't want to risk dying there, so it was smart to retreat. Yeah, so Pedo Pan can kill him if you get all the damage in, but.
And a Spellweaver beforehand. A full Pedo Pan can't kill if he's at full health. And he gave me the pattern like him. I shouldn't have risked that.
Yeah.
Okay, but
so that's a kill.
Nice.
But yeah, so if Pedo Pan does the slow startup like he was doing, you can pause and unpause, and sometimes that randomly makes it do this fast hits. I have no idea why.
Yeah. But it needs more looking.
Is that why Bloody's latest run was the new record? Was because he got that one
strike? It helps, yeah.
It is faster strike, it's just risky. Mm-hmm. Your run will die if you're going for record, and that doesn't work.
Yeah, but I think I only got like mid-40 hits, and you can get like mid-50s to 60s if it's a good Pedo Pan.
So this might be one of the worst final bosses I've ever seen in a game, design-wise. There are a billion things that can go wrong. And
I've started doing this fight a different way. Last night?
That's fine. Yeah, we worked on a better strat. Well, not, it's like generally the current strat, but... he's basically going to tank a hit here and guard, and then do the Mickey RC. And what this does is every time Ventus chooses,
Vanitas
chooses to do an attack, it cycles through him. So after this, after he does that, he's going to probably dive.
Yeah. Mickey run over to me? Nope. So this isn't going to do great damage. I think it should still be enough, though.
And he's going to be wide open after this, so he's going to get hit and have to hope he gets... Or he
gets knocked away.
Yeah.
He would normally teleport away and not get hit, but I got extremely lucky.
Yeah, that was really cool.
That's dangerous.
You never
want to cure without seeing where he's at, without Leaf Prism.
Alright, now we have to worry about the potential he could dive again after the DM, but I don't think he cycled enough.
I think Mickey needs to hit him at least once to get... Actually, no,
you're
I'm good on damage, yeah. Okay, when he dives next time, the fight's done, and I'll call time. He's dead.
Yeah,
it's fine. Time.
1:13:14.
Nice!
My PB is a 1:11 something. So.
Yeah. And that was a
gotcha tape.
Yeah, gotcha tape at minigame.
And purposely
dying the way. Okay, so bosses. All three of them met?
Yes, all three of the bonus boss fights will be done. So, it's whatever order you want
to
do it.
So, I need to switch to my.
For this.
So, you have to make different profiles depending on what character you're running to skip optional cutscenes. So, that's always fun. But, need to get my level 1 file.
That's the biggest downside of trying to speedrun this game, is if you want to be really fast, you don't want to get those extra cutscenes, so you have to make profiles specifically.
Extra cutscenes equals extra loading screens.
Yep. Specifically, the first character you beat the game with gets one extra cutscene, and the third gets two extra. So you have to beat one character, and then have one of the other two characters be the run you're doing runs with.
Yeah.
So my Aqua file, on my Aqua profile, I've beaten the game with Terra. On my Terra and Vin profile, I beat the game with Aqua. And as long, like, I can beat the game with Terra and Vin, as long as I never save it with either of them, it's fine.
Yeah, the game doesn't auto-save, fortunately, so we don't have to worry about that.
So, for all of these boss fights, it doesn't matter until Mysterious Figure, really, but I'm going to be using a Final Mix exclusive Keyblade called Royal Radiance. It's the only Keyblade in this game that actually has a special effect on it, and that's it drastically increases how much you fill the command gauge by when it's used. So that's why I'm using a new profile, because I need that Keyblade.
Plus, get that from beating Nohard, right?
Yes. Yeah. Plus it takes, you have to beat all of the Maj Arena to unlock Nohard, so I need to use another file anyways.
Yeah, these fights can be pretty rough, and he's level 1 as well, so.
Yeah.
He's gotta be like pretty careful about surviving them.
They're going to see what's probably... Spellweaver, I think, is the third most damaging ability. Peter Pan's second, and then Peter Pan's first and Rhythm Mixer's second.
Yeah.
I think Spellweaver's third.
Yeah, you get to see the other crazy damage up with assuming
yeah.
it works. They can all dodge it if they want.
Yeah. So, for the first boss fight, Alma of Ericus, I'm actually going to take that one. I'm going to make the fight a bit appealing by doing a lot of different finishers on him. That's the wrong file. I forgot I saved a new one right before this. I remade the final episode earlier, so I just talked to you, sir.
I was like,
yeah.
What?
That's my bad. For the past week, I've been practicing with the save file I use right there at the top, and the PS3 reorders save files when you save, so it moved it on me. But yeah, Alma of Ericus, I'm going to be showing off a few other finishers so you can get an idea of the type of damage I would deal with stuff that wasn't Spellweaver, since that's most of what you saw during that fight, or throughout that run.
Yeah, make so sure you get to see other ways that you could be ridiculous strong at level 1. Basically is what he's getting at. And these are all optional bosses, too. They're not regular.
Plus,
bosses.
To be honest, if I did Alma Vericus just with the Mixer or Spellweaver, the fight would be about 40 seconds. So.
Yeah.
Oh, I've got a $50 donation, donated anonymously. I want Bic to do a dance when he first gets to use the Moogles in honor of the Moogle dance ability.
Bic dance.
Also got a $10 donation from Blazion212. Hey guys, enjoying the cage block so far. Shouts to the co-op final Xemnas. Keep chugging ice cream and we'll beat BBS yet.
Yeah, so two out of the three optional bosses are actually in the Mirage Arena, which makes them easily accessible and refightable.
Hi!
So, if you want to explain, if you know, like, cool facts about Alma of Ericus or all you can get.
Oh, I just know what you're going to do.
I mean, like, about the fight in general.
Oh.
Like, how is he different from regular Ericus?
Oh, he has a lot of different attacks, and then he has, like, basically stronger. It's like, think of it like the data fights in 2FM.
Yeah, the attacks he has also depends on which character you're fighting him as. Like, it changes depending if you're Aqua, Terra, or Ben.
That seal move is dangerous, because he can choose to insta-kill you.
Yeah, he can follow that up with a one-shot.
Yeah, so at any time he could die to that, but I think that's the only cheap shot he has. Alright, so he's not invincible during this, so he's doing, unfortunately, Ghost Drive instead of something strong.
No, it's fine. I want to show off the...
That is so scary. Yeah, he tries to seal you with that move so that you can do something else.
You can actually... that seal move, if you combine it with the Rhythm Mixer finisher, you can make him invincible until he uses it again.
Oh.
That's...
That would be the insta-kill if you
yeah.
were at one.
If he did that off the combo, I would have been dead. Okay.
The optional bosses in this game are actually really fast-paced. They pretty much rely,
so,
unfortunately, on second...
With the Mixer, second strongest finisher.
They also punish a lot of normal commands, so, like, surges and
yeah.
command styles are generally some of the better ways to go about things.
The unfortunate problem is they negate a lot of commands.
I hate the Zane
John, silly,
I'm actually I was hoping he DM'd. Because his DM is really fun. His DM's one of the coolest moves in the game, honestly, Aqua.
It's pretty, yeah.
That's one of the quicker times I've had with this fight.
I know, yeah.
Closer to 2 minutes.
I was faster than I saw you do it all today.
Okay, change decks. So, you can have three different decks and those three optional bosses, so that works out perfectly for me. One deck for each of them.
That is convenient.
Yes.
The problem with this fight is the opening. You have to not actually fight No Heart right away, but you have to fight his shield for some reason to get to him. And if that means if you die, you have to refight the shield, and it's a little bit slow. It takes, like, roughly a minute or so.
You could kill the shield almost instantly if I were to use Ice Cream, but the game doesn't reload my Ice Cream between the shield and him, and I don't want to risk running out of Ice Cream against him, because I only have the amount in my command deck by now.
So you're pretty much left to Seeker Mines, and this guy can move up and avoid them?
Yeah, I've had fights where he stayed in the air, and the Seeker Mines couldn't hit him.
Yeah. The problem with Seeker Mines is
starting with this attack.
Yeah. The problem with Seeker Mines is that you kind of gain super armor during it, but it ignores second chance and once more, so if you're hit too much during Seeker Mine, you're dead.
Yeah, so like that. He was high up in the air, Seeker Mines couldn't hit him.
On the roadside, EXP.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Seeker Mines are very strong in this as well, but Ice Cream, when it works, is definitely stronger.
Okay, that should have hit enough to get me with him next one.
So this isn't like a difficult part of the fight, it's just like stalling pretty much. Like that doesn't do damage if you mash, it's just stalls.
Just trolls your command gauge a little.
Yeah, that too. Because now he has to build it up again.
Yeah. Losing my command gauge from that is the worst part of it.
Nice. Even the physical attacks of Rhythm Mixer are pretty strong when they connect. Unfortunately, they last forever.
Yeah, once you commit to one, you're stuck with it for a while.
I've tried to make it a thing on Mysterious Figure to try to combo with him, but he'll just Renewal Barrier during mid-combo, and you're stuck, like, hitting it.
I'd like to get the finisher if he'd let me hit him.
He just wants us to enjoy the music longer, I guess.
There's an entire second half of the fight for that.
Yeah, it's a pretty crazy fight. It's really hard to track what No Heart does. You'll see what I mean. He's basically everywhere at once, so you need to be really like cautious of when you're popping Ice Cream and such so you don't die.
Yeah, I'm going to try to drag him into Chrono so that he doesn't dodge with a Mixer.
Thought Armored Zemnis was easy? Wait till he gets up.
I don't remember if I changed my deck to not have Fabulous anymore. I think it's right.
I don't remember what it was.
I doubt it matters.
That's a good scenario.
Yep. Couldn't even use the force Ice Cream. You guys haven't even seen his wings yet. Calm down. Okay, he's in the corner. That's the wrong one. Ah, he's out of range.
Unfortunately, since he goes everywhere, so scary.
Oh, shit. Remember, I do have Leaf Bracel. Kyo's not going to get interrupted. Usually.
I was going to say, it can occasionally happen. Leaf Bracel's a little bit falsely advertised. In this game, anyway.
Oh, I can also get one shot if he uses a specific move as I'm leaving Rhythm Mixer. He has one move that... He has one attack that will stun you. And you are stunned long enough that he will get in another hit and kill you. It is essentially an insecure. I've never been stunned and still lived. And you are vulnerable coming out of Rhythm Mixer just like Spellweaver. So hopefully that never happens. I'm back here. Nope. Okay. Rhythm Mixer is time-based. I have... Like, it will disappear after so long. So even if he's away from me, I still want to use it.
It's every time you're at 1 HP, everyone's freaking out.
Which is half the fight.
I know.
I think occasionally I get hit.
I think the people that are don't really appreciate how Cartwheel works in this game.
Yeah, if he mashes Cartwheel at level 4, he's completely invincible the whole time. So he just needs to wait for a safe opening.
So that shield from phase 1, he can bring it back out in this fight.
And then he takes it back in like a second, probably. We don't know what it does or if it even can do damage.
take us back.
Sounds really obnoxious.
Okay, yeah, that was better than I
almost my
favorite. I'm stuck. I'm stuck in place right now, so.
Okay.
I think I get it. Mega Flow?
Nope.
That's the move that will kill you if it hits you. Because it stuns.
Yeah. And you'll be at 1 HP from it. It's strong.
He really wants to hit me with it.
He'll probably might do Mega Flare Slurry.
Yeah. It's pretty low on health.
Fortunately, he can be invincible.
There it is.
Yeah.
Oh, no. I am not used to seeing him wait this long to not use Mega Flare.
There's basically no safe time to heal in this way.
I hope the microphones can pick them up every time they gas.
You skipped like pretty much two DMs now, I think.
Yeah. So the fallback if you run out of ice cream, because as you saw sometimes where the mixer didn't do much damage, is Seeker Mines. But as Biz explained in the first section, you have Wick Wall, so you can't be interrupted, but that also means second chance of once more don't activate. And as you can see, not getting hit by him while casting something, pretty difficult, so I'd rather not have to rely on Secret Mind.
Whatever
I
use.
I like how the achievement for that fight gives you
25 minutes
to beat him.
Whenever I do the fight with Seeker Minds, I have to wait until he does the double dash to have a safe opening, or else you're pretty much auto-dead.
Yeah. So, Mysterious Figure. Fight I was looking forward to the most.
We consider it probably the worst design boss in the entire series, I think.
Pretty easily. Yeah.
As long as you're not...
If
you're not using Terra.
If you're Terra, then you can't dodge anything consistently, and he can kill you if he wants. It's really silly. Most people resort to Surge Spam on this fight because you're invincible during it, but Adam came up with an interesting strat to not do that.
I'm pretty sure it's still longer than... it's quicker than using Surges on Aqua, so...
It probably
also, does. I mentioned how Rhythm Mixer could make all Movelicus invincible. It can also softlock this fight.
So, this guy's AI can change based on what you do or what you have equipped for the fight, so you're going to see that probably instantly if you've never had before. So he's going right into a healing.
You attack twice, usually, before doing it.
Mm-hmm. So right now it looks normal, right? He's doing everything.
And now we
can see.
So if you use a D-Link in this fight, instead of waiting till the second half to go invincible, he will start spamming invisibility as soon as the fight goes off.
Yeah.
So don't expect to see him for the rest of this fight.
Yeah, it's like the game devs didn't want you to do anything in this fight except for Surge Spam, because they counter like everything. You use a D-Link, he goes invisible.
Yeah, so I explained how Peter Pan's D-Link fills up. Goofy's D-Link fills up by guarding an attack. So it's the only D-Link that you don't actually need to see the enemy and hit them. You can just guard his attacks and it'll fill up. So, unfortunately, that does mean that I need to wait until he uses an attack that I can actually guard to do damage. But I am invincible during this.
Since he's invisible, we can't target him, so you can't really see how much damage he's taking, but
yeah.
He'll probably figure
he'll die at some point. We can tell when he's at half health because they're still using his other attacks, unless, like, that one night where he never used any of them.
Surge Spam on this fight takes, like, at least 5 minutes usually, if not, like, 8. Ooh. So that move can actually knock you out a second chance once more and kill you.
It's also kind of fortunate that the Goofy Spin attack itself has a meter that doesn't really trigger a renewal barrier almost instantly.
Yeah. Yeah, renewal barrier is a little bit unfortunate that he has, because it means he can dodge a lot of that.
Also, controlling Goofy Tornado is very difficult.
Yeah,
if you're not just standing still. It's worse than Raging Storm, if you've ever used that in this game.
So, like, if you were trying... Terra doesn't have this D-Link anyway, but he wouldn't be able to, like, dodge any of this consistently.
Aqua and Vin have access to it, but Terra never meets Donovan and Goofy, so they can't do this strat.
Unfortunately, Terra's only reasonable way at level 1 to win this is Surge Spam, and even then, it can take you one try or, like, 2 hours of attempts, even if you know what you're doing.
Really fun part of this fight's about to come up, and that's trying to refill my D-Link to get the Goofy D-Link back. Once the D-Link runs out, I need to use a Balloon Metal. But the animation time to use a Balloon Metal is really long, so I need to wait for him to use 2 attacks, and he's past half health.
That was Doom he used. You don't want to get
probably
hit.
Probably won't get that off, but it's worth a shot.
He took full advantage of that.
Also, the tornado move he uses that knocks away your commands, that does push you out of a D-Link as well. So if I ever get hit by that, I have to use a blue metal and get back in it.
Yeah, it's really lucky that you're fully invisible during the dodging, because, like, Terra has cooldown in between his dodging by, like, a lot. But otherwise, this would be ridiculous. Oh my god.
What?
five dooms.
I've never seen more than three.
That's amazing.
I was a bit late with the cauldron. So, command back. Now I need a way from the either use collision magnet or hold.
The funny thing is, in the original BBS, if collision magnet grabbed you, you were pretty much almost guaranteed dead because you couldn't break out of it.
Yeah.
In FM, they fixed it so you can actually dodge out of it, so it's actually his most harmless move now because they don't know how to nerf anything, apparently. So now we pretty much, like, sigh of relief whenever we see it.
It's unfortunate that this entire strategy is based on his pattern, so I have to wait until he uses a move that I can actually...
See, like, here's the why this isn't that scary, is because he's completely invincible while dodging at 1 HP, so he just has to wait until a chance.
I just have to not be bad and drop a stroke, which is how I got hit by that tornado move in the first place.
Yeah, you have to match it pretty hard if you want to chain them, though. That's what's kind of rough about doing these fights with Ben or Aqua.
The difficult thing is keeping it up while moving the camera.
Yeah.
I wish you could all see his hands on the controller right now. It's really impressive.
That wasn't in time?
Yeah, the balloon letters are hard to get off, because he's just a fast-paced boss.
Yep. I'm not going to try it after Doom. Is that, what, 8, 9 Dooms so far this fight?
Yeah.
So being hit by the third Doom, I think, is pretty much an insta-kill. I think it's third or fourth Doom that you can't mash out of it after that point. So nine of them in one fight.
There's a way to reset it, but I don't know what it is. I don't know. I've done it. I
had no idea.
I should have highlighted it, but... I've done it with Terra, though, so... I've always wondered, because, yeah, if you get hit with it multiple times, you're usually dead. But there's some way that it can reset.
He moved really, really far away from me, though. Because of the X-Wave attack, he teleports across the screen and uses it.
Yeah.
He dashes, I guess.
It's hard enough to control this ability, much less target him when you can't target him.
Yeah, because you can't lock on pretty much at all in this fight.
With this strat, at least.
Yeah. Well, and any strat once you get to this point, past half health.
Well, the good news is he stays, like, visible for a little bit more usually if you're not using this.
Are you a bit late with the guard there? It's so risky going from a cartwheel straight into a goal because sometimes the game lags and you get hit.
Yeah.
I'm really lucky that I haven't died from that.
Because he's, like, almost pretty much dead now.
When he glows yellow like that, he's using Renewal Barrier as well, so that is healing him.
Yeah. Another fun fact is he doesn't stagger when he's invisible, but as you saw right there, when he was visible, he was getting hit, so, like, staggered.
It's late. That's that thing I just mentioned about how guarding out of a dodge roll, how sometimes it staggers when you can't do it. It's what just happened.
Yeah, it's changed by so I think it has something to do with you want to, like, kind of reset your momentum so you can immediately go into it.
Shouldn't have said anything.
But you can't, like, completely let go of the controller or else it won't go off in time.
He'd be dead if that was the PSP version.
Yeah.
But because we don't have to worry about it now, we don't even think about it now.
Yeah. Honestly, if my command gauge is half full, I'll let myself get grabbed because you can guard midway up and get hit
for
the command gauge. I only do that if it guarantees that it'll fill it, though. If it's not full, I can get hit falling down and still die.
Yeah, that's the funny thing. You can, like, Leaf Bracer cure through that and everything now. Like, it's not just air slide out of it. Like, pretty much anything that's a dodge in any way can
be. Why can't you do that last time, Aqua? I would have still been alive. Short combo. Beijing Storm is annoying since he teleports after just going a short distance, so it's really hard to get hits on him doing it. And let me get the finish for that one. And I have to refuse.
Yeah, he has no way to cure now other than guard, so he kind of has to...
D-Link's about to run out. Hopefully he uses something I can guard.
Oh boy.
And I didn't have him on screen, so I didn't see that. I need to just didn't do it in time. So yeah, when your D-Link runs out, it's like when you finish Spellweaver, the game keeps you from doing anything.
Yeah.
So the D-Link was going to run out during the Raging Storm and I would have died anyways, so that was, I needed to react faster than that.
Yeah, it's command stalls as well. If they run out while you're dodging, it actually lags so that you're vulnerable in between cartwheels, which is very silly.
That was my bad for not watching my D-Link this one. Because when you get that finish off. Just settle down. Yeah, it's just a pain that this strat's completely reliant on his pattern.
Yeah.
So when he uses moves like Raging Storm that you can't guard against, you're just stuck waiting it out.
As far as consistency, Surge Spam with Aqua and Ben work a lot better than this, but this does a lot more damage and looks
yeah.
neat.
If he gives you preferable patterns, it's quicker.
Yeah. And you can still get killed at random with a Surge strat if you throw them out too frequently, but it's not that bad. It's like, I really think the game devs wanted you to just spam surges and then dodge around invincibly until you got a chance to cure, which is silly.
I'm fine.
Yeah, you're not Terra, that's right. Terra probably would have died to that.
Well, no, I think he would have lived through it since they were close, the hits were close enough together.
I usually try to leave Bracer.
This one hasn't been too bad. It's given me a decent amount so far.
Yeah, a lot of hits.
Staying in place, which is really nice, so I don't have to move. Just a bit short. What a great move to use.
Oh my god. He can renewal barrier these, but right now he's kind of...
I don't want to take that chance because he's also MF's also attacking, and
yeah.
he could use something that would kill me.
Those orbs generated so much life.
Oh yeah.
Life with his clones.
Did I get lucky? Hey, he was nice.
Fortunately, if you use the D-Link multiple times in the same area, it loads instantly.
Yeah, after the as long as I don't use another D-Link, this one can continue to load quickly. And I disabled all my other ones, so I couldn't actually do that.
Have you ever tested this at level 99 or higher level?
No, I don't have. I don't know if I have a non-level 1 fit Aqua file.
It's the only way he knows how.
I don't have a high level Ven or Aqua, I only have a high Terra one.
Yeah, Aqua can do the Radiant Guard trick, so leveling up high on her would be really annoying.
Yeah.
Also, fun fact, a lot of people to power level on the PSP version would use EXP Walk when tape down the analog stick. Can't do that in this version. If the game detects that the analog stick has been in the exact same position for too long, it stops your movement. You have to hold it by hand and just slightly move the analog stick every now and then if you want to do it that way.
So they could program that effectively, but not other things about this game.
No,
yeah, I see.
That was the number one priority, not abusing EXP.
And might need to just leave the D-Link after this one.
Because they want leveling up to be fun as possible.
Not gonna lie, my TV's a bit vital. Oh,
yeah!
Well,
yeah. I didn't either. You missed it out on it.
That was one balloon level, right?
I think so.
That one seems really fast. Okay. So, that was Mysterious Figure without using soldiers. And I guess EBS entirely. So, yeah, thanks everyone for
and
watching.
The cage
block. Yay!
thanks for the crazy support for the Girth by Sleep bit Mora too.
Yeah, that was super awesome. Thanks everyone for all the donations during KHBOK. Raised just over $5,000. That was really cool. With that, I think we're going to take a small commercial break. And when we come back, we're rearing up for Final Fantasy VI. See you soon.
We're going to eat dinner now.
Oh, thank God.
We sure are.
Oh, yes, we are.
Yes, that is true.
Some of us get 4 hours.
Shall we bring you something?
Yeah.
Make sure it didn't go still. I'm sure.
I ate a sandwich at the start of this. I'm good. Until
oh, we're doing
that. Go change.
It's been like 6 hours.
We're going to be straightforward, but yeah, we're commercial right now.
Will it unplug that?
Yeah.
Spike, are we still waiting to get
yes.
Yeah,
yeah, I saw that.
He's got kind of late.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, if you want to maybe ask around to see if anybody has a car if they want to go.
Yeah, we took off
our studio.
We're
just going to get
down.
No. I
mean,
none of us are
going to
be
you know what to do,
Roth.
Get down.
This is comfy.
Oh, what are you doing right now?
Dying on. Oh, yes,
I know.
Interview.
I would have been nervous if you had. No, I know.
Great.
Oh, barely. No, you are.
John.
Roth. How are you doing, right?
Good night, yourself?
We're good.
Yeah. Good. Good Kingdom Hearts section.
Oh, thanks, bud.
Yeah, it was fun.
Off the donations today, the donation
from commercial.
Yeah, that bidding war was insane. I think we raised like $5,000.
It's a heartless.
Pretty cool.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
And I have it. This is a heartless.
Hey.
What is that?
Heartless.
Heartless? Yeah, it is.
What's that?
Oh, shut it. No.
Give
me your ass.
Yes.
No.
That's no problem.
Lower this. Come here.
Out of the heartless.
You have to leave now.
No. Without the heart, I'll die.
Oh. Alright. You guys are good. Commercial's over.
Oh, hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to RPG Limit Break 2015. We're here with our fourth and final runner of the Final Fantasy IV race tomorrow, going on sometime tomorrow, so I don't get it wrong again. Like one, it's early afternoon, we'll say that. Super cool we're setting this up. I am joined now by The Roth.
Howdy.
Howdy. So, how are you doing in the States?
It's great.
Is this your first time over in the States? Or?
It's my third, but first time to anything to do with computer games.
Oh, okay. Now, a little unique, you were actually one of the people that picked me up from the airport, and I found out you're here for how many weeks in the States?
Just under four.
Just under 4 weeks, so yeah. Why are you, I know this is like, this has nothing to do with Final Fantasy IV, why in addition to Salt Lake City, Utah, why are you here and what were you doing?
Well, initially it was just here for a pool tournament, just a bunch of friends and I won a pool tournament in South Australia.
Uh-huh.
And so it's in Vegas. It's just some amateur pool tournament.
The way I was described, okay, amateur, because basically people described you, it was built up like you were a world class billiards man.
Okay.
I'm just saying, FF Gamer showed me a video of this, like after you guys went pooling yesterday. Is that what it's called? Pooling, sure. you're like, oh, this idiot. And you were hitting some pretty sick shots, so
thanks.
You have a tournament after this again? What's kind of the schedule like?
So it's a 10-day tournament in Las Vegas.
Okay.
Over the 10 days, they probably attract between 2,000 and 3,000 people.
Wow.
Yeah. It's a really massive, really big tournament.
Now, in addition to playing to those, you're also playing to about, you know, 3,000+ people that are going to show up tomorrow for Final Fantasy IV. Are you nervous?
It's hitting me now, yeah.
Okay. Finally, after watching a lot of people, is this your first live marathon you've ever been to or anything?
Yes, yeah. First one. Yeah, I'm really honored to be here, to be honest.
Yeah, cool.
Very, very lucky. It's been a four-way race. I get to play with three good friends.
Mm-hmm.
So
I'm going to ask you the same question I asked Nirm earlier. It's hard to say. Explain to us a little bit about the run, kind of what goes through your head. Well, are there certain parts that make you a little more nervous than others, parts that the viewers should look out for, places where we can see big swings, boss fights you worry about?
Well, like Niren said, the Mumbomb fight's obviously one of the big turning points. Another big turning point will be our donation incentive, the Trash Can Carrot glitch.
Mm-hmm.
I actually raced with no cash earlier, and I got the Trash Can Carrot glitch first time, but no cash failed it. And as a result, while we entered the mile on mile on Z even, and then afterwards I was about 2 minutes ahead.
Can you explain, I don't know if it's been met yet, can you explain to the audience at all what they should be bidding for? Like, what exactly the Trash Can Carrot glitch is?
Yeah, normally in all the RPGs, you get to, you have a trash can in your inventory, which you can use to dispose of unwanted items.
Mm-hmm.
So we can actually use a glitch which involves using a twin to mimic other people's actions, and you can force a twin to use a carrot,
mm-hmm.
and you can force the twin to use a trash can as well.
Oh, okay.
And then the trash can does some pretty decent damage.
Is it? Yeah. Now, obviously, this is not used in any percent at all. You're saying this could be a big moment, whether you're able to get this or not?
It's actually faster to use the trash can and carrot,
mm-hmm.
but it's quite unsafe in that if it fails, the boss has still got full hit points.
Oh,
so,
okay.
And there's virtually no way to recover it because the order of attacks that we use is very, very finicky.
Right.
So you basically got one shot, and if it fails, then rip, kind of thing. You
yeah,
to just
sure.
Fight, you just have to fight the boss.
Pretty scary on a four-way type race. Do you guys do races of FF4 often?
Very often, yeah.
Okay. Are they usually pretty close down by the end? I know Poexel's held a lot of RPG relays in the past, Final Fantasy relays. I don't know how many of you have been involved in those necessarily.
Yeah. We just finished a 8-player tournament.
Oh, wow.
Four.
Okay.
And a lot of those races came down to either the level up grind that we do, because sometimes that can take minutes to find, and sometimes you can find it like on your walk.
Sure.
And Zeromus is a big troll as well. He can, if certain people die, then that can add minutes onto your run as well.
Right. So give me the prediction tomorrow. Who's going to win?
Probably our cartridges. Because... Yeah. Back attacks and surprise attacks.
That beats your
brutal.
Answer, Nerm.
Yeah. And who's gonna lose? Well.
Oh, he has this one queued up. He thought about this one.
I heard your. I've been thinking about this a lot, and if I get trolled, my Final Fantasy IV cartridge might lose.
Oh gosh. I understand.
It's any person's.
Yeah, sure. Anybody can take it. Again, we've got. I talked to Nerm a little bit about this earlier. Are these the top four runners in the game? What's the standings look like here?
Very close to it. There's El Magus, who recently is now second. He's actually 3 seconds behind world record pace now.
Oh wow.
So, is it? It's definitely we're in the top five.
Top.
Yeah,
so your first, third, fourth, and fifth. So. This was extremely exciting, I know, for Poexel and the crew to think we can get four of the top runners. A very, very popular speed guy. I know you said there was like a good 14 of you who went to the Vegas trip last week.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Was that pretty fun?
Yeah, definitely. It's been great to catch up with everyone.
For sure.
I actually meet them for the first time. And,
oh, this is the first time you all have met in person.
Yeah, I mean,
meeting up in Vegas seems like a pretty good first time to hang out.
Yeah, it's a good choice, I think.
Well... Good luck in the race tomorrow. Good luck in your billiards tournament.
Hope to do well in both.
Heck yeah, dude.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, for watching. We'll probably, I don't know if we go back to ads or not, but we'll be back very shortly with Final Fantasy VI. We'll see you all then.
Oh, let's go ahead and say this.
Yeah, oh, I didn't have you say it. Sure.
Yeah, I just appeared.
That's all right.
I'm like, oh, where did he come from?
No.
This is a picture.
I got to get out.
You got
hooked up? Yeah, it's all hooked up. So,
dang, dude.
It will be as soon as he gets the SNES on.
Oh. It's TV on and input.
Okay. And then as soon as he gets the SNES on, yes. 720
by
240.
240.
By
480.
No, actually, I have to set
it
by
240
just once.
Oh, baby. Oh.
Good sound.
That's not sweet.
One.
Oh.
Good audio.
Just pull the AV cable. That is probably some sort of dumbness on my part. I'm sure nothing.
Major.
Dude, I'm so excited for this run.
Snes is doing the thing.
No, this is just not even the right thing to do. Oh, you actually, did you switch to
the What's that?
Did you switch to the component?
Yeah.
You see what's going on here? I don't know, maybe that's more.
Is he the right fight?
That is a little strange.
That's very bright as well.
Well, brightness is not entirely sparse now. What if someone else turned it off
recently? I see.
Okay, so let me just make sure.
I just checked.
It goes red, blue, green, right?
Yeah.
You did just check. Okay. Let me make sure. I have red over here. Red, blue, green, yeah.
Sit. But is it Pummel or is it Rummel?
Oh, Ben, how far into the run is the opera scene?
2 hours.
2 hours? Okay, cool. Thank you.
Just under 2 hours.
No.
What are you seeing on this
go?
You're good.
You don't want to finish this one. This is the hypest part of the run, by the way, the seed manipulation.
Luckily, I just finished it.
Was that right?
Yes.
Sweet.
That's one reset. You guys missed 20 others.
Do you want to get comfy here? Should I sit back there?
We all like each other. Plus we octopi gotta stick together, I guess. So.
Oh, boom! Get out of here!
Get out of here! Wait a second. You're the odd one out here.
Yeah, we got three octopi.
Okay. What am I doing here?
Just need Happy Squid to like mail us his cell phone or something with the cover.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. That's awesome. That's such an awesome cover. I should look in the scene. Scene about that.
Dream Team for life.
Is anybody else think this is kind of loud to you?
Why am I even here?
It's kind of loud.
You can leave.
We can turn it down.
It's a great idea. It's a mixed call.
If you don't want to be here, you're uncomfortable. Yeah. Just probably put this down a little bit.
I don't want to draw with me.
That's fine.
You guys taking all the chairs.
Oh, must drink.
I have to sit on someone's lap.
Everybody.
Don't we have more chairs?
That was kind of weird. What just happened there? Maybe that's just how it is, normally.
It does appear to be weird.
Well, yeah, the way it's positioned on screen, that's just kind of a thing.
That's a TV.
It's the TV, but I guess that looks alright. Are you not, like, are you noticing anything less vertical?
It is a little strange.
Thing going down there?
Is it the same thing going on there?
Yeah, it looked like it. That kind of the line pattern.
Don't make me turn the console off.
That would certainly
fix it. And then you could just go.
Yeah. Then we get to adjust the estimate for 22 more resets.
That's why we have the second part. Right?
But no, you shouldn't turn the console off.
Don't do that.
By the way, is volume good or do you
want
down.
Could be.
We could stay and have it lower for sound.
Yeah,
I think it could go down a bit.
Tell me when it's too low.
A little bit higher. 13. Yeah, that's good.
Okay. I guess I have no idea what's causing the weird video thing, but there's no way to really make it wrong, so it probably should be like that. So we have to wait for you to watch through this cutscene, right?
It's just about over.
So. Yeah, just when they get to the walking.
So right off the bat, Demon Chocobo, yay or nay?
Oh yeah, I need that. I need menu background.
Are you the bearer of
menu? From her reaction, it looks like it's a yes.
I do have bad news.
Ah, okay.
It's like, we have very good news, everyone. Yes.
See that menu in the middle?
Get used to it.
Actually, the bad news is I can't connect to the Wi-Fi.
We're saying.
Good taste it is.
Don't worry, it'll be resolved soon. Here,
if you want some good news, you can hit spacebar.
I blame the demon chocobo for interfering with the Wi-Fi.
Oh, that's so bad.
Yeah.
It's so glorious.
Glorious is not a word.
That's actually a little wrong, too. The beak should be brighter. So, it actually gets
so
worse.
So, we have some very excellent news for the runner.
Okay.
It's on.
Gotcha.
I mean, we have a model right on the side there, too.
Yeah, we do.
Okay, but it's only winning by $12. So
oh, yes.
That could change very quickly.
So increase that lead.
Yes.
Yeah. Let's get some more donations.
So yeah, for, I guess if anyone is fortunate enough to not know what the Demon Chocobo is, that center save file on the screen right there is the most ugliest possible menu background for this game that we've ever been able to come up with. And that's going to be a rolling incentive during the entire run, basically up, going all the way up until the last time he opens the menu before the final battle. And if at any time, I guess as of now, if we get 13 more dollars donated towards Good Taste, then our glorious runner here will be glad to get us back to that beautiful baby blue window background you see on the top file. But if like any sane person, you want to troll him mercilessly, by all means, donate more money towards RPG Jerkbird and solidify its lead.
Yes, please donate and put it Towers Naming Demon
Chocobo. Shout out to Omagus for that one.
Yeah, shout outs to Autocorrect for that one too.
Okay, so let's just roll call first, I guess. I'm Big Fong Balls. I'll be running FF6 any percent that uses a sketch glitch.
I'm Nirm.
Feral Pigman.
Boexel.
And right before I get started, I just want to shout out to LCC. If it weren't for him, I wouldn't be here playing this. And I don't mean because he couldn't show up. I mean because he taught me everything that I know, so... However good this goes, we can thank him, and however bad it goes, we can also thank him for that. Yeah. Alright, I'm ready. Okay, 3, 2,